Look at this. These guys down here, they don't know what to make of me. I'm an alien. You know, I'm just kind of like... See, it's just... Enough.
Oh, whoa. Okay, Sid.
Was that protocol?
Yeah, close
enough. Whose protocol was that?
We shoot first.
Hello, my friends, and welcome back to PlayStation Underground. We are playing Mass Effect Andromeda, coming to PS4 on March 21st. I am here with our resident Mass Effect expert, Sid Shuman. Hello, sir.
I mean, well, thank you for the nice intro. I think, actually, you're more the Mass Effect expert, probably. I am a Mass Effect enthusiast.
But you've played Andromeda the most of the three of us, also joined by Zach Miner. Hello, sir.
I studied for years to get my Mass Effect degree and immediately disrespected.
Zach, I meant no harm whatsoever.
That is correct. So this is Mass Effect Andromeda. We're going to be taking a first look at it here. This is running on a PS4 Pro. So if you're watching on YouTube, if you're able to get yourself to a computer, turn on the 4K option, you can see it in its full potential. So I'm playing a Sarah Ryder. You can see her there. She is, I can confirm, way cooler than the other guy, her brother. Sean Ryder, whatever his name is.
Making favorites already.
She's way cooler, so just go with her.
I was always a FemShep guy anyway.
Yeah, exactly. The other thing I want to call out is this is a pretty much a low spoiler session here. So we're going to strategically cut around parts of the early part of the game. We don't get too far into it, but idea here is to just kind of give you a sense of what's in store when the game hits PS4, with full PS4 Pro support, may I add, on March 21st. Unfortunately, we can't show off HDR, and I do want to call out HDR, like in this scene. HDR looks so good. But you won't be seeing any of that on today's show.
You've been seeing it on your beautiful display at home, I'm sure.
That's correct. So what's happened here is we're right in the beginning part of the game, and, you know, surprise, surprise, the whole setup is this Andromeda initiative. These explorers are looking for a new home for humanity. They've been in stasis for 600 years. They went to a whole new galaxy, Andromeda, and they finally get to the planet that they've had their eye on. That's where I am now, Habitat 7, and everything goes horribly wrong.
As it is wont to do in science fiction.
That's right. So it's such a disaster on the ship that we've been told to sort of proceed to the planet. So this is Habitat 7. This was our best hope for an inhabitable world. And not looking so good. Look at all this lightning. Lightning everywhere.
Lucky number 7.
Kaboom, kablamo. You want to live on a planet with floating rocks and lightning? Not me. Let's get out of here, guys.
Sid Shuman wants to run straight through that.
That's right. We're brave.
You don't have any time for that. Whoosh.
I will say, you've already passed a number of things that you could interact with, and it's bothering me so much.
I know. And here's the thing is, we are going to take that approach with this playthrough, because we'll be here for days. I'll be in this this cavern looking at these mushrooms for like the next 4 hours, unless we just keep moving here.
We certainly don't have time.
I want to look at all the mushrooms, but we just got to keep going here.
Sid's mushroom tour coming... Coming nowhere, I suppose, actually.
Live from PlayStation Underground.
Look at that. A thunderous cry from my sidearm there. I'm going to holster my weapon. Look at this. Now, I wanted to call this out. This is right in the beginning of the game. Again, minimal spoilers is what we're aiming for here. I'm just going to boost jump like crazy here.
Yeah.
This is a huge, huge deal.
That's your favorite new thing, isn't it?
This boost jump, I want to call out just how fun this really is. Watch this. I'm going to do a little boost jump chain here. I'm going to go, hop, and I'm going to dash. Look at that. Isn't that fun?
Okay.
Wow. Now, did you do it?
Get up there.
You can tell. See, this was not rehearsed.
That's
whatsoever.
Right. Folks, we are live to tape right here. This
don't look that.
All right. So,
now, was that extra dash something that you've had to invest in at this point? Or
no,
that is a
standard issue move. Look at that cool shot there. Boost jump is X. And it has combat applications, as we'll show off a little later in the demo. The dashing as well. You can string it together with the boost jump, but the dash is handy for getting the F out of the way, if you will.
Oh, my goodness.
Now, should I say trouble or a mystery to solve?
I say let's stay optimistic, a mystery to solve.
Don't know, but it's our job to figure it out.
That's right.
That's the way, Sarah.
That's right. So I'm here with, I believe that's Liam. He is a part of the expedition. We're just trying to find a new home for humanity, folks. That's all we're trying to do here.
I'm a simple man, and I have simple needs. Just a new home for humanity.
I don't know why we had to fly 600 light years away or whatever for this, but why not?
Well, it's the role of the Pathfinder.
That's right.
Is it not?
That's right. That's my pops too.
Uh-oh. Hey, I'm gonna go out on a limb and say these guys are up to no good.
That's the cat. And again, minimal spoilers. So if you want to have completely virgin eyeballs, then maybe don't watch anything about the game. But these are certainly
no. Keep watching
keep
our
watching.
Video, please.
Let's follow protocol here.
Take it easy. We only get one shot at hello with these guys.
That's right.
Yeah. You are strictly business on this playthrough,
that's
Sid,
correct.
And I appreciate that.
Yeah, I usually take that sort of pro sort of stance here. So
is that how you are at home? You just want to.
Oh, this is
you
interesting.
Just play the good guy.
That's right. So look at this. These guys down here, they don't know what to make of me. I'm an alien. You know, I'm just kind of like.
That man's with us.
See, it's just. Enough.
Oh, whoa.
Okay, Sid.
Was that protocol?
Yeah, close
Whose
enough.
Whose protocol was that?
We shoot first.
I'm gonna walk forward with my arms open until I pull out my gun.
And we're dispatching these enemies.
That's right.
Promptly.
So, what I'm gonna do is, this is right in the beginning of the game. We've met the cat. We've landed on Habitat 7. I'm gonna jump ahead a little bit.
Okay.
The magic of editing.
Okay.
And we're gonna check out something a little bit further ahead. This is the Nexus. This is sort of the staging ground for all the various explorers from all the different races that are out here in Andromeda. It's also having serious problems, and let's take a little look at what's going on here.
Pathfinder, no time for our beer yet. This place is a mess. Security is, let's call it, strained.
I can believe it. Nexus is running on empty.
So they're out of supplies. They've been waiting for us. They've been waiting for the human expedition to arrive.
Everyone was trained and armed for Frontier. We know cat are dangerous, and now we have to worry about our people too. No idea where they went, but they left mad.
Okay, so something worth calling out here is these conversation tones. We kind of flirted with this a little earlier, but this replaces all the Renegade Paragon stuff that we've seen in the last game. So this is sort of the, I believe that means logical.
I see that little cog iconography there.
Right.
Exile may have been a sanitized death sentence.
What a shit show. Pathfinder.
Oh yeah, and I'm the Pathfinder now, by the way. No pressure. Spoiler alert.
Congratulations.
Were you not the Pathfinder earlier?
No, my father was the Pathfinder.
Ah.
But due to various reasons that fans will find out on March 21st, I am now the Pathfinder.
Got it.
See what I mean? I'm trying to respect those spoilers, you know?
Clearly.
That's right. So, okay, we're just going to have, this is called the Nexus. We're going to have just a brief romp here. I'm even going to run up these steps to make it slightly faster. See that? I respect your time, viewer. And
there's so much to see.
I know.
Dude.
All
yeah.
this.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, look at,
I want to talk to all these. Are we scanning?
That's
hello.
Right. We're scanning. I don't think there's anything scannable in this immediate vicinity, but we'll be back to that guy. I wanted to just, I know a lot has been said about sort of the new combat mechanics. I wanted to just kind of ensure Mass Effect fans that,
yeah.
or assure them that there's a ton of all that conversation stuff that you love.
Excuse me.
Wow, and so were some of those dialogue options unavailable to you because of previous choices you made?
No, they're
or?
Ones that that I actually
engaged
already with
already. Exhausted.
Yeah. So
got
I'm
it.
Cheating a little bit here. I'm using okay. the magic of the save
Look
file.
At the hair animated on the back of her neck. That
I
is
know.
Amazing.
That drove me crazy too, yeah.
How many tries
crazy
is that?
In a good way, right?
Less than you'd think.
Crazy.
Yes, crazy.
Wow, that's wild. Worlds,
exiles, hostiles. We can't just plop down
really hurts
and
if you try to tug on
fences.
Guys too.
Yeah,
you don't want to tug. I don't think anyone was advocating for tugging on them.
Well,
hey,
I just
Sarah,
want to be clear.
Sarah,
PS
you got
Underground
a little something
on.
Here.
On
neck
right.
hair.
someone sat behind Sarah Ryder in math class.
Support each other.
So,
on space math. It was space
math. Not sorry. By
Tan. So Addison here is not exactly the kindest person. But unfortunately, she has a lot of power.
I bet we could maybe win her over in due time, perhaps?
That's right. So that's just a quick look
scanner
at some of the conversation. We'll come to that scanner. That's a quick look at some of the conversation and dialogue
okay.
options you're going to have. I literally spent hours going around this place. It's right in the beginning of the game, meeting characters, scanning things.
Oh,
again,
man.
I'm having a
scanning
hard time.
Scanning characters?
Scanning characters. No, you can't scan characters.
I really want to talk more about the scan. Are we going to be able to see the scanning?
The
in
scanning
action?
Is going
to
be in full effect. See, the thing is, look at all this stuff. People I can talk to, documents I can read, computers I can interact with. But,
scans you can scan.
That's right. But we don't have a ton of time, so I want to keep it moving.
Okay.
So let's jump ahead, and we are now aboard the Tempest. Something Ooh. Happened, and now I have a ship.
Ooh.
They hand it right
another,
over.
Man, another beautiful view.
That's right. It's it's pretty.
Let's just briefly call it again that we're playing this on the PS4 Pro in beautiful 4K resolution. If you're watching on YouTube, be sure you click over and are actually viewing this on a 4K display. You're making me want to get a new TV, Sid.
I'm telling you, I've tried everything in every move of the book to try to get a 4K TV. But it's a good looking game. HDR is the other thing. You're not going to see that here, but HDR is, I would say, as much or more of an upgrade than the enhanced resolution.
Ooh, strong words.
Even in SDR here, you're seeing some of the contrast between the shadows there. And
yeah, it's an advantage. Look, I can get a little cinematic with it. Kind of crane the camera around. Not after worth through. It's a good looking game. If the best we get
is what we make. So we're on the Tempest. This is our new ship.
That's right. So, so we'll get into the scanning stuff a little bit more here. But basically, when you scan, you earn these research points.
Oh, God.
And you spend, there's three different types, see? This is the Milky Way research points, Helios technology, and, who's to say what could be there? and you can use it to, like, build different weapons and things like that. So there's blueprints and yada, 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 and you can lose your mind and all this. But we're just gonna keep it moving. Development is another thing that you can do.
Wow.
You can craft things. You can make various things and so forth and so on. You could also find them. You can go find them and buy them and anything else you like.
Wow.
So that's a glimpse at that. It.
Yeah, and this already feels kind of much more RPG-centric than the later games of the last trilogy.
That's right. I think that's fair to say, yeah. I can buy things here. I have $100, though. I don't know if I can afford too much of this right now. Because, again, we're very, very early in the game. But, incendiary ammo. I actually didn't realize that was in the game. So, good to know. Good to know. I mean, the game just continues to surprise and delight at all times. So, let's see here. Let's check out the bridge.
Yeah, so this seems quite a bit different from the Normandy.
Very different. Very different. Now, I could go down those ladders. I could go up and around and all over. But again, we're trying to respect people's time. Don't want to spoil all the different characters you're going to meet here. But it's a really cool ship. It is set up extremely differently from the Normandy. Look at that. That's hope. So, trajectory locked, Nexus control. Is that a Solarian?
Oh.
I like the Solarians the best.
Yeah, Jack, me too.
A pleasure to be here, and to meet you, of course. I'll be piloting the Tempest at your word. Quite the ship, but it'll take a Pathfinder's guidance to see us through Helios.
Oh, my.
I'm new to this. Being a Pathfinder, running a ship.
Stay humble.
You'll be fine. As for the ship, I can help. I knew the Tempest when she was a blueprint.
Of course, you're super smart.
I was test pilot for the Tempest's early prototypes. I admit, I'm itching to see how she performs out here.
So we haven't even taken her for a spin yet.
We haven't even taken her for a spin. This is coming straight out of the dock.
The console syncs with your implant. Just swipe, touch a destination here, and the nav system calculates everything. Very efficient.
Easy to get lost in the dialogue in this game.
Oh, I know, yeah. We're all sitting still. Like, I like Solarian.
Is anyone ready? Look, it's a Taurian. Taurian?
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 I'm not sure.
Failure isn't an option.
Continuing to see dialogue choices there. All right. Have you seen that already? I mean, you're early in. Have you seen those choices kind of, you know?
Oh, yeah, they're everywhere. Yeah. It's if you're into Mass Effect based on the conversation, the relationships, this is going to be right up your alley.
Yeah, she looks like trouble.
Yeah.
No, she looks and sounds awesome. Did you hear that accent?
Unless you've got something to say for the log.
Irish, I think.
Or Scottish?
I think
which one was it?
I
wasn't.
Know.
I couldn't really hear her.
Is that maybe a little Australian?
Well, I mean, that could be too.
If we're both wrong, that'll be hilarious. We'll beat the odds, and we'll beat them again. You guys were talking when she talked,
you know,
so I missed
true.
It.
I know it.
So I'm sure we'll have a lot of very generous Mass Effect fans writing in to tell us how wrong we were. Prepping to depart.
This is the big moment.
Tempest.
Tempest, go.
Just crashes right away.
Game over. So basically, the Nexus was kind enough to lend me
departure
the scout vehicle,
the
Tempest.
Godspeed, Pathfinder.
and we are out looking for leads on what happened. There was a sort of a disagreement aboard the Nexus. This again, this sort of staging ground for all these different explorers that are out here. So, let's take a look. Failed outpost puts an end to that idea.
Maybe we can turn things around. Sid, can you scan any of these?
We're going to like heavy duty scan Sid here in a second. I know.
We missed her talking again, by the way.
Be patient.
Well,
I don't think it's Australian accent, though.
I think it's Irish.
Okay.
Possibly Scottish.
One vote for Irish and or Scottish.
Scottish-Irish.
Very
Irish.
Different.
System, Pythias. Andromeda Initiative Habitat 1. Designated EOS.
It was supposed to be an easy first step. Until
no wow. Okay.
Let's zoom in here
L2.
A little bit.
L2.
L2 to scan. Hold the scan.
I recommend an immediate examination of EOS.
Oh, we will.
Wait for it.
That's pretty.
And this...
Whoa! All right.
Scan it!
So... of the signal on Habitat 7. The sense that I got was that there was not sort of the...
Is that possible?
The same scanning, like mining seven, kind of stuff that was no done in some of the last games. I don't have all of the secrets figured out just yet, but...
Of course. Who does, Sid? Who does?
But you can see that we're seeing kind of the minerals that could be available
right.
there, so those probably tie into some of the R&D options back on the ship,
Indeed
right?
they do. Indeed they do.
Oh my gosh.
Now let's land. Yes. All right, so I'm pretty satisfied with these weapons. I don't want to get too fancy. I might throw a mod or two on here, if
okay.
you don't mind.
Oh, I don't mind at all, Sid. You take your dear sweet time.
Yeah, scope. That'll be handy.
We have a new home for humanity to find. Okay?
That's right. That's right.
You don't want to rush a project like that.
Ready, Freddy.
That's correct.
We're all that ready.
Okay, let's skip ahead to EOS itself all right. and
yeah.
skip all the preliminaries here.
Get some boots on the ground.
Okay, and here we go. We're on EOS.
Whoa! Perfect.
I didn't get my driver's license until I was 29. Did I ever tell you guys that?
Wait, is that real?
No.
Oh, okay.
I'm lying.
Because, you know, I wouldn't put it past you.
Oh, easy.
Easy, you got it.
So
Sid,
there's
what is
a lot
this vehicle
here.
That you're using?
I'm using the Nomad here. Hold on. It's an all-terrain vehicle. It's supposed to be up to this kind of work.
I can see that.
That's right. So we're here looking for leads to some of the folks, or what happened, rather, to some of the folks who were on Nexus. So unfortunately, yep, I have to jump out here because it's awfully steep.
Got it.
My boost jumps are a little more useful to me than those big crazy tires, if that
Got
makes
it.
Any sense
Understood.
To you.
Understood.
All right. And
looks like you are dealing with some radiation
boom.
In this area. Too.
Yeah, low level. I got that life support in the lower left-hand corner. It's keeping me going.
You're like, I'm fine. Keep, I'm fine.
Keeping my ticker ticking.
Now, do you have to return to the Nomad to kind of replenish
that
life support?
Yeah, but it lasts a long, long time. So okay. let's do some scanning
Ooh,
here.
Scanning.
Oh, yeah. I just got some scan points there.
On planet and planetary scanning.
That's
like,
right.
Quite a bit.
Forget
That's
about
right.
it.
So you'll lose.
Game over, guys.
So this is right here. I'm in kind of a safety bubble now from the radiation outside.
Oh, interesting.
And
that's
a whole
safe.
It's a whole mystery. But yeah, this is sort of this this energy field, scourge they call it, and it is for some reason apparent here on this planet as well as the planet is Habitat 7. So the plot thickens, if you will. So the Yeah, so here we go. Let's find out what's going on. This is some ancient alien technology, some ruins here, it looks like. You can scan a little more if you like.
I'm getting
points each time I do it. All those points are going to roll in.
I'm really upset at all the scanning spoilers.
I know. Massive here. Spoiler. I'm scanning this. I'm scanning that. So
alien
I'm not going to...
device.
I'm actually
Whoa.
Not going to be able to
working,
use this
but
thing.
I'm just getting random symbols.
That's right. Glyphs. So let's see where these little yellow lines go, you know?
All right.
I think I can get up there. What do you think?
I could provide analysis via the scanner, Pathfinder.
See, the boost jumping
I would guess no, you can't get up there, actually.
But you can.
But you can.
Oh, wait, I think it's from the back.
Oh, okay then. Well.
The boost jumping is extremely addictive in this game.
Now, it's been a bit, but overall, kind of... traversal and interacting with this world just seems far more dynamic
much
than
more
it was
so.
In the
much
PS
more
games.
So
way more involved than the original trilogy which I don't know if we mentioned, you do not necessarily need to play in order to play Andromeda. Andromeda is its own starting point in the story.
That's right. I've heard from some BioWare employees that there's like kind of some little bits and pieces of lore you'll pick up, but it's totally its own separate story, its own protagonist, its own stakes and all of that. So it has little to no crossover with what we saw with the Shepherd Years, okay? So that was a sort of a simple puzzle there. Whoa,
easy there, Sid.
That's right.
Building connection. I apologize for any discomfort. The system seems unstable.
That's my AI, Sam.
Ah.
In case you were wondering.
Sam controls the ship as well, I presume.
Yeah, I don't want to get into spoiler territory, but let's just say kind of an AI buddy.
Okay.
Again, trying to be respectful.
I'll give it a shot.
All right.
Wait!
Bam.
Whoa.
Or I will push you down.
Who's this colorful character?
Whoa,
interesting.
You've come this far. Just let it ride. I've been studying this tech for months. I don't know how you activated those glyphs, but you have to let them cycle.
I'm gonna push her off.
Nope, too late.
No, I got it. Yeah. That's right.
Don't like being sat on, huh?
Oh, woo. She's actually super cool. I like her a lot.
Who am I? I mean, it's obvious who you are. I saw the ship swoop in. You're a pathfinder. Was beginning to think the initiative just made you guys up so the rest of us wouldn't lose hope, but you're for real, huh?
I love her coat.
Yeah, her coat's awesome.
Can I have her coat?
What about you?
Are you for real? You were going to tell me who you are.
I might just be the solution to all your problems.
Perfect.
So she's here studying these sort of ancient alien ruins.
Look at that.
And I've done something by activating that console.
System has stabilized. I'm establishing a connection.
Happy to do all the Foley work for you, Sid, if you'd like.
Uh-oh.
Oh, crap.
Okay, I'll stop.
I know these things.
Okay, we're going to check out some of the biotics and
yes,
whatnot
please.
Here.
Boom. No, what class are you playing as here, Sid?
So classes are kind of have gone away for the most part. There's now profiles. So I'm playing as a bit of a vanguard, I believe, or biotic.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what abilities do you have here?
I have a pull, push pull, and an energy lance weapon. So they had this sort of concept of primers and detonators. So I'm gonna prime. And then,
Well, your prime was too powerful.
Prime was devastating there. Oh, really?
Easy.
Just cleaning house here.
Yeah, you wrecked shop, my man.
Right.
Oh my gosh, what is that?
Oh.
Whoa.
Oh, hello.
Breacher.
Something over here. Get him.
If you scratch your nomad,
that's right.
Coming out of your salary.
My first tangle with the Remnant was a lot messier.
The Remnant?
These monoliths, the Observer and Assembler bots, they're all the remnants of something much bigger.
So they're sort of like a security force for these ruins.
I hate long. So, the Remnant. Like, my name's better as PB.
PB.
Ryder, you've been studying this Remnant technology? What have you learned?
Plenty. Not nearly enough. It's old, it uses glyphs, and it's well protected.
Not very insightful analysis there.
Great, thanks, PB.
Preach.
Atmosphere manipulation? Maybe. Fits the model. All Remnant tech is connected. You interfaced with this monolith somehow, and now it's pinging the others. If you wake them up too, they must lead to whatever master switch might fix the radiation.
Interface with the monoliths, follow the connection to the source. Easy enough.
Can't be that easy.
Just don't piss off too many observers.
See, there you go. Here's the catch.
Here, take my nav points. I've got to figure this interfacing out. Just be careful. This planet's all kinds of strange.
All right, let's get back in that nomad. We got more work to do here. Where did I park it? Oh, yeah.
Nav points. Is there a map of these kind of on-planet?
There is. You can go here.
Ooh, okay.
It's pretty well organized, right?
Yeah, this is new.
Not too shabby.
And if I do again.
That's right. So let's go over here. Pop in that there, Nomad.
Folding doors, of course. only the finest for Ryder and her crew.
Now, the vehicle controls and whatnot are... This Nomad is just so much better than the Mako.
Okay.
That's what it was called, right? The Mako?
The Mako, yes.
Yeah, it does a lot of the same things, but it's just much more interesting. I could kick it into all-terrain mode right now, so I have, like, additional... Can't go as fast, but I have, like, way grippier torque.
Ah, cool.
Interesting.
Upgraded my torque, I think is how you say it. And I want more speed right now.
So you can upgrade individual elements of your... Of the Nomad.
No, that's just a button press. You sort of shift it into...
Oh, so when you say you upgrade your torque, it's a...
Yeah, I pressed a... exactly.
You press the button.
Yeah, let's go this way. Oh. I see some trouble ahead. Let's hop out.
Trouble.
My senses are detecting Ket technology, Pathfinder.
Just like in the movies.
Slide across the the hood.
Now, this weapon does like a charge-up attack. It's kind of fun.
Cool. Digging it.
I really want to do a biotic combo. Come on, I can't do these combos right. Oh, I'm using the wrong move, that's why.
Well, yeah, that'll do it. Oh, hello.
There we go, there biotic combo. Very satisfying. Okay. I don't know what that is, but I'm staying away.
Yep, this did not look welcoming.
Bam,
oh,
right in the face.
Looks like the kind of thing that's hazardous to Ryder's
health. Blam.
Hello, goodbye.
See, the enhanced maneuverability is a big deal.
Yeah, that makes the combat feel way punchier and much more fast.
That's right. Oh, this guy's bad news. I need to do a combo on him for sure.
Combo him right
combo
into a
failed.
Fountain. Right next door.
Oh.
Sid, easy, watch out.
Nice work.
Nice
now
job.
I could, you know, screw around there and download stuff and scan stuff, but let's keep moving.
Well, you've got navs to point to.
That's right. All right.
Wow, this
looks pretty,
looks
right?
Fantastic, yeah.
Gosh darn.
I think I go this way.
Who needs to go outside when you can just explore lush alien worlds with Mass Effect Andromeda?
That's right.
Coming to PS4 on March 21st.
Whoa.
Easy.
So actually, I made a bit of a wrong turn here, but it's kind of, I think it's kind of an interesting example nonetheless. It's sort of this sort of, you know, quasi open world. I mean, it's quite large. You know, there's a whole valley there I can go down, but I'm not going to do it. Turn around.
And so if we were to go down there, we might find some things to scan or some resources to gather.
More, you know, some skirmishes, various things of that nature. So
the scenic route.
I surely
that's
did.
That's really all there is to it. You didn't take a wrong turn. You had a happy accident.
Well, I have no sense of direction, but I actually do know where I'm going right now.
Well,
I can believe it.
I believe PB did give you some nav points.
Oh, I guess I could look, right? Should I look?
PB does not like to be kept waiting.
No, certainly not.
And
she's a woman of business. She's an Asari of business.
That's where I'm going.
It's Asari, right? Is that?
Yeah, she's Asari.
Okay.
I
looked
to
Zach, but Zach was not committal with his facial expression.
What are you talking about?
Oh, no. Watch out for the squish.
Oh,
devastating.
Poor little one.
Well, no, he was going to spit acid at me. I guarantee
okay.
it. Been there, done that.
He was going to spit acid. I guarantee it.
Yeah, see, here's the all-terrain mode, so I can hit L1, and I can kind of get a little extra torque.
Still doing that Foley work.
Whoa! Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. Hey!
Oh, and you're gonna stab your Nomad there? Pop those tires?
I need to get back
in. Sid,
everything's under control.
I don't know what you're doing, bud. But,
I'm the Pathfinder.
You just need to find humanity's new home.
I'm the Pathfinder.
I'm the Pathfinder.
As you blow out the tires on your intergalactic all-terrain vehicle. Uh-oh. Happening there?
That's a forward station. Or
yes.
Easy.
Whoa.
Give me control of my camera. Okay, here we go. And this will be the final little adventure we'll have here in our play session. Oh, by the way, I can mine. Kind of interesting.
Oh, my God.
I haven't figured all this out, but I'm launching a mining probe.
Oh, right. Okay, so those were the elements that in our planetary scan
right.
we found were rich here.
Now, I don't exactly know how all that all works. I think I just leave it alone is my theory, and things will happen.
Sid.
So while we fight...
I can't believe you don't know how that works. That would have been the one... I would have spent 15 hours just trying to mine.
Look, we're different people. It's clear.
It's true. It's true.
Zach, I think you and I are on the same page. That oh, yeah. Right there.
Is there anything to scan here?
Clements and Miner Mining Co.
Wall. Clements and Miner Mining.
Actually, I guess it is a kind of my namesake.
I mean, it really is.
That's yeah. right. You're a miner.
These ones don't seem hostile.
Oh, I was wrong. No, Sid, it wasn't shooting yet.
I will say, for being called the Observer, not very observant.
No,
you were
not
able
at
to get
all.
Up pretty quickly.
Wow. Arose by any other name.
Now, could you be kind of commanding your squad to do different activities here? Can you put them on different settings? Or?
You know, I actually didn't look too deep into
squad,
that.
Squad, play poker.
Okay.
The other games did let you do that. I don't know how far they go with this one.
Okay.
You can upgrade them and give me a combo. That's all I want. You can upgrade them. You can give them different weapons. You can do things like that. But I didn't get into the squad control stuff, because to be totally blunt with you, I never ever did it in the other games.
Yeah. Sid, you were missing out on a key element of strategy.
No, that's incorrect.
That's very correct.
The AI does a good job.
I assemble by shooting you.
That's right.
I detect a high level of remnant encryption here, Pathfinder. To continue, you will need to decrypt it.
We got more of this stuff. Let's see here. I think I remember what to do.
I like how he says Pathfinder. It's just, he's just looking around.
I'm finding a path.
Look, he's being thorough. You want your Pathfinder to do the job,
there
right?
There we go. Look, see?
There it is.
I'm not crazy.
Whoa.
So I will point out that in HDR, this looks so cool.
Oh.
I mean, it looks
super
cool in 4K standard definition range.
Let's see here.
Or dynamic range.
The high dynamic range. Got one of those there glyphs.
Get that glyph.
Let's get that other one. Watch this little
move.
Oh, God.
Woo!
Oh.
You got like a jetpack. My favorite.
That's your favorite? I couldn't tell.
That's right. Yeah. And this guy. This is the interface that controls this. Right? It is interesting that they get into some sort of, you know, borderline platformy.
Yeah, like environmental
segments.
Puzzles
yeah.
going on here. Very interesting.
I don't normally associate that with Mass Effect, but it's a hell of a vertical leap.
Well, it's a whole new galaxy, Sid.
Oh, he's stuck behind the pillars. Oh, gosh, Sid, you came dangerously close to the edge.
That's right. I like to live dangerously. Okay, got that. Oh no, hover. That's fun. It's just fun stuff like that, you know?
Yeah.
We'll see if anything's
just
scannable.
Scan this space pot.
Oh, is that a scannable over there? No.
No.
What's that? Get some precious research points.
No relevant data.
Oh. Okay.
Precious research denied.
Interface.
Oh, this thing is crazy. So there's a really hard puzzle here, and I'm gonna struggle immensely trying to complete this. You guys wanna help me?
Wait, are you joking, or do you actually need us to do stuff? I thought you already knew the answer.
This has to be like the first puzzle in the game, Sid, right?
It's certainly early in the game. So the idea is nothing can repeat, whether in the square quadrant or it can't, like in a row, a column, or in the square.
Okay.
I think I'm on the right path here, though. Put that little guy in there.
Some Sudoku, space Sudoku vibes.
I know. It's a little different. It's a little out there.
Oh, man. Sid, I'm getting a headache just from looking at this.
I know.
This is tough.
I know. It's a real... I think I got it. Oh!
What? I think I got it. Alert, alert.
Security breach.
Now I got to deal with these jokers.
If you were gonna fail, you might as well just fail right from the start.
We should give a little peek behind the curtain here. This is one of the more prepared for episodes of Underground I think we've ever done. There's a multi-page printout of all the different activities we want to hit.
That's right.
But we didn't count on old puzzle foiling us.
Old puzzler yeah, Shuman here.
Let's give this another shot. We can do it. Okay, let's.
Oh, I thought it would just force you into the next
section.
No,
I gotta do it. Look, we're gonna do this thing. The fate of humanity.
All right, how many different glyphs can you select from?
Like five. Ish.
Okay, well, first let's start and figure that part out.
I'd rather just blindly progress.
You've got to get it right eventually, right? How many combos could there be?
How many possible combinations could there be? There's seven open spaces and five combinations.
We'll just methodically work our way right down the list.
Okay,
I think I got it this time.
You were so sure before.
I got
don't
it this
press.
Time.
Ryan, Sid's got
Hold
it.
On.
Sid's got it.
Hold on.
Sid's
Let's
got it.
Just
we got
fact
it.
Check it. No,
got it.
You don't
Done.
Know for sure.
Nothing in a row or column can be the same. So,
right.
Unique symbol in each slot for rows and columns.
Right. So let's just go through.
Bit All by right. bit.
Then you go down. Let me just go down. Boom, 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 boom.
Compelling
boom,
TV
boom,
here.
Boom. No, this is important. Everybody's going to love this. Okay. Now, how about inside each square?
They also cannot repeat in there.
Right? So.
I think we're good.
Yeah, I think you're good.
Oh, yeah.
That's
Mass
right.
Effect.
That's right.
Roll end credits.
And that's the end of the game.
And
folks.
That's how we finish the game.
No.
I see pathways lighting up all over. The monoliths are resonating. QEC contact?
Where'd I park the car?
Oh, whatever's happening, they're definitely connecting. You did good. Keep doing more.
Dude, where's your car?
Pop back in here.
Seriously? Can't catch a break.
All right.
Where to now?
The final leg on our journey. How do you read maps again? Okay. Oh, that's not far away. We can make that. Whoa.
Stay on target.
This is an intricate driving scenario here. Oh, easy.
Sid, might I suggest laying off the boost and just taking your time on that? On
okay,
that
I'm
one.
Gonna I'm gonna carefully creep my way down this mountain.
Oh my God!
What?
Are you kidding me? What are you? Okay, you're good. You're good. Easy. Oh, beautiful.
And they call it an all-terrain vehicle,
yeah,
right?
Yeah,
I mean,
they don't
come
call
on.
It that for nothing.
We gotta keep moving here. We're falling behind.
Yeah, you gotta keep things moving.
Sid, your mining computer is out of zone. Nope, back in.
They're just taking pod shots at
fine.
You.
I mean,
fine.
It is interesting to see BioWare kind of go in a direction that's a little bit. I mean, I wouldn't go so far as to say this is like full blown open world, but it's very large.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of stuff going on, and there's a lot of.
Would you call it wide linear?
I like that term, wide linear. Who came up with that?
I'm sure someone smarter than I did.
All right, well that's good. Okay,
I
and
love these huge remnant technology pedestals, what have you.
Pop out. Another mystery to solve.
Clear the cat. That's the mystery. Facility of some kind. Solution.
So contextual cover this time, by the way, no button for it.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah.
Get out of the way.
It actually works really well, and then when you want to flip back and forth, you click R3.
Ah, okay.
Love it. Oh.
Uh-oh.
Oh,
uh-oh.
It's a showdown.
Oh, gosh.
Behind you. It's a dinosaur.
Oh, my gosh, what the heck is that? Where did that thing come from?
They're like wraiths, they're called. They're like stealthy lizard.
Stealth
monster.
Dinosaurs?
Yep.
Make sure you get the fatty meat off of it.
Fatty meat's the most valuable meat. Oh, yeah. I want to hit him with the... Oh, devastating. Come on. Oh. My biotics are just not enough right now.
It.
Got him.
Now, is that a shield or a portal?
These are like barricades, you know?
Barricades, yeah. Not portals to another world.
Ah, bam!
Whoa! Mm. Jeez Louise.
Muscle my way in there.
Ryder, use the strategy that we taught you.
okay. Oh, we got some.
There's a dance party up there.
Got some fresh faces up here to blow away.
I don't know if I'd say that those faces are very fresh.
No, that. Oh, Sid, you gotta be careful you don't just dash yourself right off the edge.
This weapon's pretty fun. Just, I like that charge up attack.
Yeah. Ugh. Whoa, Liam! Liam, get out of the way, bud.
All the weapon effects look fantastic, yeah. Too, by the way.
Oh, yes! I love it. Right off the side.
Now, Sid, I'm not saying you should do this, but theoretically, do you think that you could drive the Nomad through this area?
I don't know, really actually. I think the barricades would make it tough.
Okay.
Yes, another one off the cliff. There's a lot going on right now.
Yeah, there really is.
This is not just the, oh my gosh.
Wow.
Line them up like dominoes, man.
Ugh. This is one of these heavies. I hate that gun he's got. Come on. Can I get a combo finally?
Nice.
Oh, they keep they have to combo. They're doing combos on my stuff.
Stealing your kills.
They're stealing my combos.
Last hit. Stolen.
That's frustrating.
There's no I in team, okay?
There's an I in Sid, though.
There is an I in Sid.
Right there in the middle.
Right there on that second spot.
Look, I mean, there's just so much I can interact with right here. I can do this and that.
You
and
turn on that
let's
thing.
Scan it. I don't know. Yeah. Sure. Scan this.
Scan that.
I'm getting points. And just to give a demonstration is all. Oh. And then turn this guy off. And let's see what's inside.
Okay. What could it be?
Let's get to it before there's any more Ket.
Whoa.
Oh.
Ooh.
Narsty. Seems like Krogan work.
Oh! It is Krogan work!
I think we're just about out of time, unfortunately.
Come on. Are you kidding me?
Look, there is a lot more. I skipped over so much as it was. There's tons more in this game. Mass Effect Andromeda is dropping March 21st on PS4. It's got awesome PS4 Pro support, cool 4K features. It's got HDR, a lot of other good stuff, too. So definitely one for the RPG crowd. I think a lot of folks are going to like.
PlayStation.